address it. He says, while I don't mean to question free speech in principle, how can we be so confident that it will truly lead towards the truth and not the opposite? In other words, to continue the metaphor, we can explain the chemical process that is disinfecting. I am wondering if you can convert this explanation back to the sphere of free speech. So, yeah, it's a bit of a complicated question, but I think it's a really good one. So I am a free speech absolutist, and this is what I've said. I think that so far in the world, the United States has the best conception of the idea of free speech. And one of the key elements of that is that hate speech is protected as free speech. And the reason I think that's important is because I think that when you're talking about people's freedom of speech, you're not just talking about their freedom of speech. You're talking about your freedom to hear what people are saying. And I think that that's actually a very, very important right for people to have if we're going to have an open society where there's a free exchange of ideas. As for people believing, you know, all the fake news and everything, I think that that's an unfortunate side effect of people being able to say what they want to say. But you can't go about restricting that. That just comes with it. And a lot of times,
Secular Jihadists is an increasingly influential podcast with much of its growing audience in Muslim-majority countries, advocating for atheists, secularists, and enlightenment thinkers. We want to reach out to more people. If we reach 500 patrons, we will be able to translate our shows into Arabic, Urdu, Persian, Bengali, Malay, Turkish, and other languages in these countries. Help us get there at patreon.com/SJME.